So I'm going to create the video that we're going to use for the audio for our practice problem. There's a variety of programs you could use to do that. I'm just going to use a free one called ScreenChomp. And I'm just going to leave us with a blank screen. So I'm going to hit the record and then record my audio. A train slows from 85 meters per second to 35 meters per second in 12 seconds. What was the train's acceleration? How far did it go in this time?
A train slows from 85 meters per second to 35 meters per second in 12 seconds. What was the train's acceleration? How far did it go in this time?
Pretty cool, right? So then we click the share button. And it sends it off to the interwebs where it's not searchable. And then we wait for a few seconds. We're going to click up here. And we can see it's preparing my video to share. So what it's got to do is got to turn it into some sort of streaming thing. But we're not going to stream it. One of the reasons I like ScreenChomp is I can tap here. And it'll pull it up on a website. And then if I scroll up, I've got a download link. So I can take that download link and download the file and drop it right into my Keynote. Now, one of the things you could do, if we copy this link, so I'm gonna copy this link. So I just clicked and held until I copied it. If I quit out of this app, I'm gonna go to a different app that I have called File Master. File Master is another free app. And it's kind of awesome because it lets you download stuff from the internet that may not be downloadable. So I'm going to click on the downloader. And that brings up basically a web browser. And then you can paste in your link, or you can go to where you need to be. Click go. And it's going to give you the option. So we're going to say download. I'm just going to give it let's go ahead and give it some sort of a name so that we know what it is. I'll call it Audio 1, confirm, and then it'll download it. It didn't take long because it was a very small file. We'll click back. And here's our Audio 1. Now, if I click and hold on it, I get a lot of options. So I'm just going to say save to album. That of course means you have to have given File Master access to your photo library. But now it's in your photos, and so you could actually from here import it straight into your Keynote on the iPad version of Keynote, and it would work just fine too. Or you could do whatever else you need with it. Anyway, a couple of cool apps that you can use to create basically audio for your Keynotes. Because remember, for some reason, this new version of Keynote doesn't allow audio files to autoplay, and if we set it to link only, we can't even click to make them play.